companies purchasing several distinct items every week, every month. What is the best approach to deal with the so diverse purchasing ecosystem? That's why the purchasing portfolio matrix is so cool. In this video, we answer three questions. 1. What is the purchasing portfolio matrix? 2. How to use the matrix to evaluate an item supply risk? 3. How to use the matrix to put focus on the most valuable items? Bear with me and enjoy the lesson. In my time in purchasing, I learned that supply chain and purchasing management are intensely correlated, and they have two fundamental objectives. 1. Bring resources to the business at a competitive price. Acquire materials and components also at a competitive price. 2. Keep supply continuity. Keep the company running. Keep the operations and production doing their work. Therefore, purchasing is an indispensable function to achieve supply management goals and, at the end, the main business goals. What is the challenge here? The challenge is to formulate strategies against supply disruption at a competitive price point. Peter Kraljic developed a matrix to simplify how the purchasing organization should approach the procurement process. The purchasing team should evaluate some supply challenges, such as 1. Long-term availability of critical materials and components. 2. Mitigate supply complexity and uncertainty. To make it simple, 1. Pay attention to items' relative value in the production process and in the product value. Evaluate how hard is to get the item, material, or component. We can do a better job by placing the components to be purchased in a matrix. The matrix has two dimensions. 1. The item's value related to the cost of the whole production process relate to the entire product value. For instance, if a component costs $1 and the product $100, it has a lower relative value if compared to a component that costs $20. 2. The level in which it is difficult to get to acquire to purchase the item. We may ask, how difficult is to buy, put the component available for the production process? It is a kind of risk measurement. Considering that, we can divide the components into four groups. First, the components that have a relative low value if compared to the overall cost and are very easy to get. 2. The components that have relative high value if compared to the total cost and still are very easy to get or obtain. 3. The components that have a relatively low value if compared to the total cost, but because of some peculiar reason, they are not easy to purchase. Last but not least, there are few components very expensive and very difficult to acquire. Let's talk about the first group of components, low value, easy to get. We call these components routine items. Usually they have many sourcing alternatives. They have a low cost and it's very easy to buy. The strategy here is to simplify the purchasing process and, of course, the supply process. Make it simple. Don't waste time and money on these items. The second group are the components that are easy to acquire but have a significant cost relative to the production or product cost. We call them leverage items. Why? Because the company has many potential suppliers. Therefore, the purchasing department can leverage the bargaining power and maximize the commercial advantage. Now the third group is a kind of mysterious components that we call bottleneck items. They have relatively low cost, but for some reason they are very difficult to acquire. For instance, when Japan was hit by a tsunami a few years ago, several automakers in the US had to stop the production. Why? Because of the short supply or some pigments. Pigments? Yes, pigments. Pigment is usually very cheap and its participation in the car cost is very low. For some reason, these components embedded some specific technology, although the low cost. The best strategy is to develop actions to ensure the supply continuity. Critical items are the essential components of the product or for the production process. These components are crucial to differentiate the product, to the company profits, sales, to turn customers in. They may have lots of technology, intellectual property, participation in the cost bottom line. Therefore, you have to put effort, dedication, to bring these components at a competitive cost and as well to ensure the supply continuity. The recommended strategy is to develop a good partnership with critical suppliers. Every time you are assigned to purchase a component for your company, keep in mind these metrics. Try to figure out in which category the component falls. This may help you to understand the context that you are working in and to find the best strategy to buy the component. And again, keep in mind the two primary objectives of any supply chain manager or purchasing professional. One, bring resources to the business at a competitive price. Acquiring materials and components also at a competitive price. Two, keep the supply continuity. Keep the company running. Keep the operations and production doing their job. We work hard to help you to get better marks, be prepared for job interviews, and excel in work meetings. You can send your questions in the comment area below. I'll be pleased to answer all of them. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to Americo e-Learning.